Welcome to the Cisco Netacad Introduction to Networks video series by Jason Johnson. This video is Module 5, Number Systems. The objectives in this module will be the binary number system and the hexadecimal number system. And I want to point you to the description below in this video. I have a playlist of videos, I think about 4 or 5 videos, that cover the binary numbering system, how to convert binary to decimal, decimal to binary. And I also put a link to a web page for converting hexadecimal to binary and back and forth. It's a very handy website. You should check that out down below. The binary number system. Binary and IPv4 addresses. The binary numbering system consists of ones and zeros called bits. And just to back up a bit, we normally use the decimal binary, our decimal system in counting. We count from 0 to 9. 0, 1, 2, you know, use our hands, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, or we start with 1 and go up to 10. But we use a place 10 digits, and it's called a decimal system. In this networking and in the computer world, we work with binary, and it consists of ones and zeros, so two places. So the decimal numbering system has 0 through 9 on the decimal. Host servers and network equipment use binary addressing to identify each other, ones and zeros. Each address is made up of a string of 32 bits. So a 1 or a 0 is a bit, and you need to know that. So that's a bit of information you need to study for your exams. A bit is a 1 or a 0. It's divided into 4 sections called octets. That's another term you need to be familiar with, is an octet. That's 4 sections called octets. Each octet contains 8 bits, or 1 byte. So 8 bits is a byte. 8 bits is a byte, 1 byte, or 8 bits is a byte, and then you have each octet has a byte. Well, each octet contains 8 bits, 1 byte, and it's also separated by a dot. For ease of use, people use the dotted notation. It's converted to a dotted decimal system. So when we look at this down below here, so we have ones and zeros here. We have all our octet, you know, our 10101010. Dot, and so we have our 4 octets, and when that gets converted, though, over here on the right-hand side, we convert the binary over into decimal so it's easier for us to read. So instead of me trying to read, if I was to give you an IP address, and I was to say, oh, it's 110100001, 101000110, you sound a little bit like Bender off of the cartoon Futurama. So instead of doing that, we convert it to decimal to make it easier for humans to understand. So in this case, this one is 209.165.200.225. So if you were going to say that number, that's how it would sound. 209.165.200.225. And then we would assign each one of our IP addressing down here on that dotted decimal system. Now, when we look at the binary positional notation, there's a couple of different ways to convert binary. This one here in this video and in this module for the Cisco uses the positional notation. That means that a digit represents different values depending upon the position that the digit occupies in the sequence of numbers. So the decimal positional notation system operates as shown in the table here. So we have a radix 10 place, 10 place, 10 place, 10 place. This, you know, position number of 0, 1, 2, and 3. And, you know, the tens place, the hundreds place, or the ones place, the tens place, the hundreds place, the thousands place. That's decimal. Over here, we would say ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, and we would calculate that based on the place. So if we had 1, 2, 3, 4, that would be 1,230 for our tens place and 4 for our ones place. That's how we do it on the decimal side. On the binary positional notation, it works just the same way, except our places increase by 2, because instead of going up by 10, I mean, 1, 10, 100, 1,000, we go up by 2's places. So we 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, 64, 128. So we have our position numbers, and then each time it doubles. So that's the easiest way for me to memorize it and keep it straight in my head. It doubles each time. You can also calculate to the place value. So 2 to the 7th place is 128. 2 to the 2nd place is, you know, 2 times 2 is 4. 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is 16. That's how you could use the positional notation system. And down here, we would say where our place is. And if we were looking at a binary number and we had a 11000000, that would be 128 plus 64, because see, our number here is 128 based upon the 28th place. So 2 to the 7th power is 128. 2 to the 6th place is 64. And so since we have a binary notation in the 128 and 1 in the 64, we just take those two numbers and add those together, and that's 192, because all the rest of them are zeros. We have no binary position in those slots. Now this chart here is shows you the positional way to do the charts. So you have the 128, 64, 32, 16, 8, 4, 2, and 1. And then depending upon where your place is, it just shows you how you can calculate each one. If you watch, again, I'm going to point you to my playlist for the videos that I have in the description below. I have a video that shows you a very simple way on how to create a chart for when you go into a test or a certification where you can't have a calculator. It's a really easy way to calculate binary to decimal and back and forth. So in these cases down here, we can look in this one here. We have a binary place in the 128 and 64. So you just take those two and then you get the 192. Down here, we look at this one. We have 0000. And when you write binary out, by the way, you wouldn't write the leading zeros. This binary number would be written out as a 1011, just as a side note. And so we would just take that one as 8. Because 1 times 8 is 8, 1 is 0 times 4 is 4, 1 times 2 is 2, 1 times 1 is 1, so 8 plus 2 plus 1 is 11. And down here we have 1010, so we have an 8th place, a 0, a 2, and then not an 8th place, but 8, 0, 2, 0, you add those together and you get the 10. And it works back the same way too, if you had a decimal number, and you can just convert it right back the other way. And again, check out my videos below in the playlist and you'll be able to have a quick and easy video on showing you how to do that. Now the binary positional value table, it is useful in converting a dotted decimal V4 address to binary. You can use this method. This is one method to do. I have another method in my videos below. And yes, I keep pushing those videos below because those are very simple to be able to do too. And it's a chart that you can easily write down in an exam as you get ready to take an exam. But here you'd start in the 128th position. The most significant bit is the decimal number of the octet. It's equal to or greater than 128. So is it equal to or greater? If no, you record a binary of 0 and you move on. And you move on to the next one is 64. Is it greater than or less than 64? And then you move on. If it is, you put it in there, you subtract 64 from that number. The remainder, then you go down and find what the next remainder is. So if yes, you record a binary 1 in the 128th position, subtract 128 from the decimal value, move to the 64 position. Is it larger than 64? If it is, you subtract 64, put a 1 in that binary position, and then you continue on all the way until you are down to 0. So here's an example here. If we're going to convert decimal 168 to binary, is 168 greater than 128? Yes, it is. So we enter a 1 in the 128th place, and we subtract 128 from 168. So we take 168 minus 128, we have a 40 remainder. So is 40 greater than 64? No, it is not. So we record a 0 there. Is it greater than 32? Yes, it is. So we put a 1 there and we subtract 32 from 40. Subtract 32 from 40, we have a remainder of 8. So is 8 greater than 16? No, so we put a 0. Is 8 greater than 8 or equal to? And that's the one thing with math, if you're really into math, really know, it should be at greater than or equal to. It is greater than 8. It's not greater than 8, but it's equal to it. So it is greater than or equal to 8. So you record as one place there. 8 from 8 is 0, so you have zeros in the remainder of the place. So you can do that on any binary, any decimal number to binary, and binary back to decimal. It works really easy. Now, when we write the V4 address, routers and computers only understand binary. So while humans, we work in decimal, routers and computers work in binary. It's important for you to gain a good knowledge of how the two numbering systems are used back and forth, and especially in networking. So when we write a dotted notation out, dotted decimal, 192.168.10.10, we need to know how that converts to binary. Now, you don't need to do it in your head, but you are going to be asked on exams, especially in this course, to convert binary to decimal. You're going to need to know how to do that. So you need to know how to do it on that chart and convert those back and forth, especially, or at least to the 128th place. at least to the 128 place. So in this one here, 192, we would take that to that chart, and we would convert and do that conversion, and we'd get 1100000. 168, we would convert that. 10, you know, is 1010, 1010. So we can convert those back and forth rapidly or easily without a calculator. Now, the hexadecimal numbering system is a little bit different because it's based on 16. So instead of based on decimal of 10 or binary of 2, it's based on 16. So it gets, it can be a little confusing because it looks different, but it really is in its basic form just like decimal and binary. It just uses a different place system. So to understand V6 addresses, you need to be able to convert hexadecimal to decimal and back and forth. So hexadecimal is a base 16 numbering system using the digits 0 to 9, that's your first 10 places, and then letters A through F for your up to 16. So it is easier to express large numbers. It's easier to express a value as a single hexadecimal digit than a 4 binary bit, because binary numbers, if you write them all out, are really long. And we can convert those, and we can use hexadecimal because it saves space in our programming and on the network. So hexadecimal is used to represent IPv6 addresses and MAC addresses. So let's take a look here. So V6 addresses are 128 bits in length. Every 4 bits is represented by a single hexadecimal digit. That makes the IPv6 address a total of 32 hexadecimal values. So the figure on the right here shows the preferred method of writing out an IPv6 address, with each X representing 4 hexadecimal values, and each hexadecimal character group is referred to as a hextet. You need to know that word. That's a hextet. If you're asked that word, a hextet is a 4 hexadecimal character group. So this is a hextet right here, this FFFF. Okay, so this has been module 5, and what did we learn in this module? One is binary is a base 2 numbering system that consists of the numbers 0 and 1 called bits. Decimal is a base 10 numbering system that consists of numbers 0 to 9. Binary is what hosts, servers, and networking equipment uses to identify each other. Hexadecimal is a base 16 numbering system that consists of the numbers 0 through 9 and the letters A through F. And hexadecimal is used to represent V6 addresses and MAC addresses. V6 addresses are 128 bits long, and every 4 bits is represented by a hexadecimal digit for a total of 32 hexadecimal digits. And then to convert hexadecimal to decimal, you must convert the hexadecimal to binary, then convert to binary to decimal. And then to convert decimal to hexadecimal, you must convert to decimal to binary, and then to binary to decimal. And I'm just going to put a note there that if you're using a calculator, if you have a Windows system, you can use the calculator on the Windows system to convert back and forth. You may not be able to use that for an exam, so you need to be able to do this on paper. Okay, so this has been Module 5, Number Systems, in the Introduction to Networks video series by Jason Johnson. I hope this has been helpful, and remember to click the subscribe button, and I hope you have a great day.